Hi, let's talk about the aerodigestive pathway. So as we've discussed previously, the more proximal portions of the respiratory pathway are also shared largely with the digestive system. And so areas like the oral cavity and the pharynx are also digestive pathways as well as respiratory pathways. And so we call them the aerodigestive pathway. Now let's take a more broad view of the proximal portions of the respiratory pathway. Superiorly, we have the nasal cavity. The nasal cavity anteriorly has a nasal vestibule. And then posteriorly, the nasal cavity is completely surrounded by the cranium. What we're looking at here is the lateral wall. And that lateral wall has three conchae or turbinates as part of it. There's the, let me erase this, it's a little in the way. There's the superior nasal concha, the middle nasal concha, and the inferior nasal concha. Now the superior and the middle are of the ethmoid bone. So oftentimes they'll be referred to as ethmoturbinates, whereas the inferior nasal concha is its own separate bone. Now, inferior to each of these conchae are meatuses, and the conchae can even partially surround the meatus. Meatus, as you recall, is a tube-like passageway. So just inferior to the superior nasal concha is the superior nasal meatus. Inferior to the middle is the middle nasal meatus, and inferior to the inferior is the inferior nasal meatus. As these conchae are surrounded or invested by mucosa, they're going to increase the surface area of the nasal cavity and bring as much air into contact with that mucosa as possible to moisten it and to warm it as it's inspired. These nasal meatuses are also regions where the paranasal sinuses and other areas, such as the nasolacrimal duct, are going to open into the nasal cavity or drain into the nasal cavity. Now, that nasal cavity has a medial wall as well, and that medial wall is the nasal septum. And the nasal septum has three components to it. Anteriorly, we have the septal cartilage. Posterosuperiorly, we have the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid. And then inferiorly, we have the vomer. And this nasal septum will also be invested by mucosa. This just happens to have the mucosa stripped away so that we can see these elements. Now, posterior to the nasal cavity, as we move through two openings called the choani, we'll enter into the nasopharynx. The nasopharynx is then contiguous with the oropharynx, which is then contiguous with the laryngopharynx. Now, as we look at the oropharynx anteriorly, we can come across the oral cavity. That's roughly there. So the oral cavity has an oral vestibule, so that's the space outside of the teeth and the gingiva, and then the oral cavity proper. That oral cavity proper will be the region into which the salivary glands drain, and it is largely occupied by the presulcal portion of the tongue. So the tongue has two components, a presulcal portion and a postsulcal or pharyngeal portion of the tongue, because it is within the oropharynx. Now let's focus on the pharynx now and really see what elements we have in each portion of the pharynx. So let's first look at the nasopharynx. So there's the choani, and then there's the soft palate. So there are two elements here that you're going to want to know about. The first on the roof here is the pharyngeal tonsil, also known as the adenoid. So this is a mass of lymphoid tissue. Inferior to that, we have the opening to the auditory tube, also known as the Eustachian tube or the pharyngotympanic tube, and in association with that, tubal tonsils. As we move below the plane of the soft palate, we're in the oropharynx, and that is going to include the uvula. And then anteriorly here, it's difficult to really discern, but there's a region known as the falsies. The falsies anteriorly has a muscular fold called the palatoglossus, and posteriorly has a muscular fold called the palatopharyngeus. And so the space between the two is the falsies. And within the wall of that falsies, the lateral wall, there's a tonsillar fossa. And within that tonsillar fossa are the palatine tonsils. Now it is this region, the fossae, where the root of the tongue is located. And the root of the tongue is covered by lymphoid tissue called the lingual tonsil. So not only do we have the palatine tonsils, but we have the lingual tonsils in the oropharynx. And then, if we can see it here, here's the epiglottis rising up. There are two scoops between the epiglottis and the roof and the root of the tongue called the epiglottic veleculae. So veleculae, plural velecula, for just one of those. And so this is going to be a region where saliva can gather and not trigger the deglutition or the swallowing reflex. So below the level of the epiglottis, we have the laryngo pharynx, and that laryngopharynx is going to have the laryngeal opening because the larynx will sit anteriorly to the laryngopharynx. And just below the level of the cricoid cartilage, approximately at, you know, the level of C6, we'll have the entrance to the esophagus. And so it's really here in the laryngopharynx that we have the concentration of this aerodigestive pathway, because anteriorly, we have the respiratory pathway, which is going to include the larynx and then the trachea. And then posteriorly, we have the digestive pathway, which is going to include the esophagus. Thank you very much for your time.